हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक इन दिस ऑनलाइन कोर्स ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिक्स। सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन अबाउट कपल, वी हैव सीन हाउ वी कैन डिसोल्यूट द फोर्स इनटू अ फोर्स एंड अ कपल। सो नाउ लेट अस सी हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ नॉन कंकरेंट फोर्स सिस्टम। इन प्रैक्टिकली यू आर नॉट going to face any situation if like in that situation only one force is there. There will be multiple forces and they will be non-concurrent system. It is not necessary that always you are getting the concurrent force system. So that also we must know how to deal with this type of system. So this is a body, it is acted upon various forces F1, F2, F3, and these forces are non-concurrent. Why these are non-concurrent? Because they are not passing through a single point. So what we can do, we can first transfer all the forces in a form of force and couple at point O. Okay, so this is force F1, this is force F2, and this is force F3. So while shifting force F1 from this point to this point, we must be replacing a moment. What is this M0? This M0 is summation of all the couple which are occurring at point O while transferring the forces, like summation MO is M1 plus M2 plus M3. M1, M2, M1 is the couple which will be induced at point O while we are transferring force F1. Okay, at point O. M2 is couple induced while we have transferred force F2 from this place to O, and similarly M3 is couple induced at point O when we have transferred the force F3 to point O. So this is clear, I think. So what is this? Is 1, this is 2. So what is the third step? So again we have to draw this body. So what we can, these are now concurrent forces, so we can replace all the forces with a resultant. So this is point O and this is the resultant R, and the couple summation MO. Now the final step is to find out the intercept. So this is point O. So what we can assume or what we can interpret it from this thing, if like summation MO can be written as R into D, if what we can do, we can transfer it to a distance D like this. Okay, and this is the distance D. So this, in this way we can we have computed the resultant force R. This was our topic, resultant of non-concurrent force system. So this R is the resultant, and we have to define first R is unknown here and D is also unknown. Okay, so if you are not getting it, don't worry, we will solve some problems so that you will get your concepts clear. So let me just recap, let me just tell everything again, because it is not that simple. It is actually simple, but you have to be very focused. So this was our initial system, F1, F2, F3, three forces were acting, these are non-concurrent forces. What we want to do, what is our motive? We want to calculate the resultant of these non-current forces. How we can do this? In the previous lecture, we have seen that we can transfer a force to a point, and while transferring it, we will be putting F, and a moment will be induced, or couple will be induced at a point where we have transferred this force. If you are not getting it, just watch the previous lecture again. You will get to know what I am talking here. So what we can do, these are the forces we want to take resultant about point O. So first thing, we have to transfer all the forces at point O. While doing this, what extra thing is going to come is moment or couple, it will be generated. So while transferring F1, we will get M1. While transferring F2, we will get M2. So we have written it as summation MO. Summation is a addition sign. So all the moments we have added, or if like the force orientation is this, so it can be minus also. So you have to take accordingly as per the sense of the moment. It can be M1 plus M2 plus M3. It can be M1 minus M2 plus M3. It can be any combination depending upon the direction of moment generated induced at point O. Okay, I think clear till here. So now we have got F1, F2, F3 as concurrent forces. So these forces can be replaced by a resultant. So this R is the resultant of these forces. What again, now we want to remove this couple from here. So what we can do, we can think of summation MO is equal to R into D. Okay, so D is the distance between the resultant R and at point from point O. So this we can just shift it by distance D. Distance D is here, this is lever arm or moment arm, so that the resultant R we can get. So these are the two unknowns which we have to calculate. So R will be composed of Rx and Ry. Similarly, D also Dx and Dy. So these are components, X component, Y component, and this is component of the displacement force and distance. So I think you have got some little bit picture is clear here. So let us just check how we are going to calculate the direction. And so R can be written as summation fx square plus summation fy square, and alpha tan inverse summation fy upon tan inverse summation fx. So this is the orientation of R from x axis. So alpha is this and D is summation mo divided by R. So I hope this is clear to you. So let me just solve one problem. You will get to know what I wanted to convey from this till this point. So question is, determine this concept you are going to use heavily, like this from here actually mechanics has started. Till now we were building the foundation, now we are going to build the building. Determine the resultant of the system of forces acting on a beam as shown. So one beam is given, so just search what is a beam. You might be knowing from your basic civil engineering, but still just search it and write your answer in the comment box. I want to see whether you are aware of this term or not, so that I can tell you in the coming lectures. If you are not responding, that I will get to know that you all are knowing, so no need to explain it. Okay, so this is a beam, some beam. So this is the given beam AB. Okay, one force is acting, 20 kilonewton here, adjacent to it is 30 kilonewton, and 20 kilonewton force is acting at 60 degree from this beam. Fine. Now we want to know the distances where these forces are acting. So this is 1.5 meter, 1.5 meter, 3 meter, and this is 2 meter. I hope this is clear. I will, if you are, this is 20 kilonewton, 30 kilonewton, 20 kilonewton, 1.5, 1.5, 3, and this angle is 60 degree. So we want to calculate resultant R. So resultant R is having two components, Fx and Fy, or Rx and Ry. It's up to you what, how you want to denote it. Okay, so what is Rx? This is the solution part. So if you want to try it, you can anytime pause the video to try it, and again come back to video and check whether you have done same or you have done something different. Rx is summation Fx. So this is X and this is Y. Okay, so 20 kilonewton is along Y direction, so this will not contribute any force along X axis. Fine. This 30 kilonewton is also vertically acting along Y direction, so it will also not contribute any component along X axis. This 20 kilonewton force is inclined, so it will have one component vertical, one component horizontal. So vertical component will be along Y axis, so it will contribute horizontally. So, but we are taking right hand side as positive X. This is positive X. So this, the this force is acting like this. So if you are taking the X component, so it is acting towards left. So this means 20, this is cos, this is sine 60. Okay, sorry, we want to take X component, so this will be cos 60. Cos 60 is half, so this is minus 10 kilonewton. Minus 10 kilonewton means 10 kilonewton towards left. Okay, now Ry is summation Fy. So positive Y is in upward direction, this is acting in downward direction, so this is minus 20, similarly minus 30, similarly minus 20 sine 60 degree. So you will be getting minus 67.32 kilonewton or 67.32 kilonewton in downward direction. Okay, so this is Ry and this is Rx. Clear? Ry is there and this is here. So our resultant is something like this. Okay, so we want to calculate this angle alpha. So first calculate the magnitude of r. So r is simply summation fx square summation fy square. Just put these values 10 square plus 67.32 square. You will be getting 68.06 kilo Newton. Okay. So alpha is tan inverse. Summation fy is 67.32 divided by 10. So actually this was minus, this was minus, so minus minus, let me just write it. So tan inverse 6.732. So alpha is coming out to be 81.55 degree. Okay. So this is the now we want to calculate, also we want to know what is x intercept. Let me just add so that you will get a little bit more clearer picture. So let me just write summation ma. So let me just put, this is a point A. We want to write the moment of all the forces about point A. So I hope you are seeing this. Now it is visible. So point, this is clockwise, okay, force here, point here, so this will be clockwise. So clockwise we are taking positive, so force into distance plus summation is there, so we want to check all the moment of all the forces. So now 30 into 1.5 plus 1.5 3. Now the y component of this will give the moment, x component will be passing through this point only. So moment about any force along this line about this point will be zero. So y component was how much? 20 sine 60 into 3. 4.5, 1.5, 3 plus 3 is 6. So this is coming out to be 223.92 kilonewton meter. So this is summation MA. So summation MA will be equal to RY into X. This thing, if you are able to understand, then you have understood the mechanics till now. How it is coming? It is coming from Varignon's theorem. What that theorem was telling? If a system is applied by many forces, so this moment we have taken individual. Now we have calculated the resultant. We can replace the resultant. Okay. So if you will solve, x will be 223.92 divided by ry is 67.32. So x is coming out to be 3.326 meter. So this means 1.5, 1.5, so resultant is acting somewhere here. Okay. So this is the point where this resultant, let me just make it, so we can replace all these forces with this resultant R. So this is the resultant, this is x intercept, this was the angle 81.55. So I hope दिस लेक्चर इज क्लियर टू यू. सो इफ यू आर हैविंग सम एनी ऑफ द डाउट जस्ट आस्क मी, आई विल सॉल्व सम मोर प्रॉब्लम्स इन द कमिंग लेक्चर्स. सो दिस इज ऑल फॉर टुडे. थैंक यू वेरी मच.